Hello, hello, everybody. It is 12:19 a.m. Central Time on Tuesday, January 24th, 2017. And man, I'm pulling a late nighter. I thought I was going to be in bed by now, but there's no way. I've actually got a few things that I want to get through here really quick. And I got a stack of viewer mail that came into me from around the world. And I figured it would be a good time right now to get on and just quickly open up the international packages that came in and the other letters that came in. I'll open tomorrow because, I mean, there's many letters in here. There's not that, it's not that terribly many. So we got five letters and three packs. Let's get right into it. Now, I said I was going to be doing a beer with this. Now, of course, do not drink unless you're over the legal drinking age. And what I'm drinking here is a Warsteiner. This is sent to me by a viewer. A Warsteiner. Here, let me make my screen much larger. And what's up to everybody over at Twitch? Wasn't that fun to go over to his channel and give a much love thing? Wasn't that great? That was so much fun. I'll tell you what, guys. They don't do that on YouTube. Nobody shows much love to one another. It's really, really cool. So, again, subscribe to their channel. Always do that. When you find new people, subscribe. Wow. Whoa, I'm looking washed out. Look at that. Look how white I look. Okay. Well, I am pale. But that is, I think that's the light shining on me a little bit. All right. Well, let's open the Warsteiner. And this Warsteiner 1753 Oktoberfest Special Edition. Now, this is the Oktoberfest, so it's obviously a couple months old. It's okay. Beer's always good. It'll stay good for a year. All right. And I'm drinking out of a mug. Now, this thing is the coolest thing in the world. This was sent to me by a viewer. See this on the underside? You put it down, and look, can't knock it over, and it's so, but then you can just easily lift it straight up, and you pull it straight up, and it's not a suction cup either, it's just, it's so your cats are, you can't knock it over. It's really, really cool. So, anyways, sent to me by a viewer, the beer sent to me by a viewer, and the mail sent to me by a viewer, and by the time I'm done drinking the beer, the mail should be open. Obviously, this will hold a full pint. So here's our full. Here's our beer. Okay, all right. So by the time I finish the beer, when I finish the beer, I will be done opening the mail. Hopefully, right? Okay, let's do this. First, let's get a sip of the beer and wish cheers. 3.0. Well, it has no bite, no taste, no after. You know how there's some beers that really give you like a real center of the tongue or tip of the tongue, like a real bitter or sour taste, and then you've got your box and your stouts that go to the back of your tongue and the top of your mouth. This one is just like, I don't want to say it tastes like apple cider, but it almost tastes like a light apple juice, but it's a beer. Okay, anyways, so let's get into it. Let's do the packs first, then we'll do the mail. Now, I told you guys, I got international mail from Italy. So check that out, okay? International mail from Italy. Look at that Italian post. Here, take a good look at the screen. See that? Italia. And an international pack, and I don't want to show this, it's got their return address on it. This comes to me from Canada, from BC, Canada. We also got another international mail from Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. And we got a pack from Bloomington, Minnesota, and I'll cover their return address on here. But look, we've got, look at the little kitties on there. See the cat? Now look up behind me on the wall. See that? Isn't that great? And look, they've got like a cat on top of a volcano. Nine Lives Mountain. So cool. My viewers are awesome, man. And then the other male, Tehachapi, I'm butchering that, California, Mr. Pink. Let's see, Cranston, Rhode Island, Sand Springs, Oregon, Monroe, Ohio, and our letters from, we've got two from Amy, our moderator in Pennsylvania. We've got one from Sycamore, Illinois, another from Oregon, and another from Maplewood, Minnesota. So a couple different ones from Maplewood, Minnesota. Let's get her done. By the way, get her done, my theme, Adepto Perfectus, okay, is Latin for get her done, in case you didn't know. Adepto Perfectus, get her done. I'm sure the Romans used to say that to one another. All right, so this is coming to me from Bloomington, Minnesota. So this is not an international one. This comes from Sandy and the Cats out of Bloomington, Minnesota. And this has all the cat stuff on the front. Really cool. Thank you for all you do to help others. And this looks like, I don't have to, some kind of clothing maybe? Let's see what we've got going on here. Oh, my viewers are always so thoughtful and everything. If you guys just have a question, you can send me a question. I will try to answer the question when I do these unboxings. Okay, right off the bat, this is what I see. Look at that. Meow. Looks like Miss Wednesday when she was a little baby. Wednesday is the Midwest Early Earthquake Warning Cat, the M-E-E-W. She says mew when there's going to be an earthquake. That's a joke. Okay, here we go. Hello, Michael. My name is Sandy, and I won't read your last name. And my hubby Patrick and I live in Bloomington, Minnesota. We have 3 cats and spoil them with glee. Smiley face. This cat quilt. Oh, they gave it away. Okay, well, I got to stop right there. Hold on. This cat quilt. Hold on. You gave it away. What is this? Okay, a cat quilt. Have you ever heard of such a thing? What is this? We've got 2 hearts, peace up top, the Pacific Ocean in Hawaii with volcanoes, the Kitty Chronicle, Wall Street Whiz forecast, tail growth, windy weather report, the chilly calico. What is that? This is great. Okay, hold on. This cat quilt is filled with catnip inside, so if your cats get a whiff of it, she or he may get a wee bit crazy. Smiley face. I found a couple of fabrics in my fabric stash that have a couple of volcanoes, LOL. Oh, you made this. You made this. Oh, my cats are gonna love you. Okay. My fabric stash, a couple of volcanoes, LOL. I hope your feline enjoys it. It was a joy to make. Thank you for all you do to protect and warn people of possible quakes. You're a true watchman on the wall, calling out the warning. God bless you. Michael and family, meow. Meow. Here, let me get it up close so you can see this. Oh, whoa. Back, on the back. Look at this. Guys, look at this. Oh, wow. Oh, this is, well... My cats are gonna, it's so nice that my cats are gonna be, well, after they eat all their treats, they're gonna lay on that and spread out. Oh, wow. You're gonna get a thank you letter back from me, a little Dutchsinse care package, maybe a little Dutchsinse merch, maybe a couple Dutchsinse stickers or something. I have much to send back, but I'll try and send much, something to you. Thank you. That is very thoughtful and kind. That is. Oh, I love my viewers and their creativity. Cheers to you. Isn't that cool, guys? I see chat going by. Isn't that cool? Oh, man, my viewers are so awesome. By the way, I've got my cat calendar that was sent to me by a viewer here, and here we are on the 23rd. Oh, no, it's the 24th. Hold on. Stray of the month. Oh, bright-eyed Dexter was born under a house in Marine Mercado's office in New Orleans, Louisiana. Meow. If you can adopt a cat or an animal, adopt a cat or an animal. It's a responsibility, though. It really is. It's no joke. So don't do it unless you're ready to take on responsibility, but there's so many little loving animals that need, and they'll make your day. They'll make your day when things go south, guys. When everything else is going wrong, you might, if you have an animal that you love, it will love you on that. It will sense when you're having a bad day, and you'll have it on your lap or rubbing up against your leg, and that will make the biggest difference for you sometimes. And it gives you something to fight for if you're living on your own or you don't have a kid or whatever. All right, this is a letter coming out of Italy. Tanto amore to my people from Italy, air mail. I'm going to save this. Of course, anytime I get something international, we've gotten stuff from Africa and Italy and New Zealand and just all over the place. This comes from Christiana I won't read your last name, but general region I would say is that Ancona, from Ancona, Italy, I think. All right, let's see what we've got going on here. A holiday card. What is this? Embossed sparkles on the top, okay, and it says Bao Natale. Oh man, I don't speak Italian. Ooh, what is this? Oh, we got stickers and everything. Okay, hold on one second. And we've got some printouts. I'm gonna read the card first and then we'll go through the printouts. Okay, here we go. All right. Thank you, wishing you and your wife a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. You are great. Much love. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, T.Y., thank you. Don't be scared. Be prepared just in case. Smiley face, and that's just one half of this. Look at this. Can you see the reflections on this? Look at this. Okay, now, here we go. Hello, Mike. Here is Christine from Italy. I just wanted to thank you so much for all the great work you are doing. I am an admin of the group on Facebook called Gruppo Monteraggio Terremoti per la Italia Michael Janich Dutchsinse. That is the Midwest. By the way, here's to me being from the Midwest, United States, and butchering every language. Here, let me take a sip on that. I bet Warsteiner is not Warsteiner. The beer I'm drinking, I bet it's like Warsteiner. Okay. Okay, so serious now. Gruppo Monteraggio Terremoti per la Italia Michael Janich Dutchsinse, she runs the group, where we post the earthquake in Italy and from the southeast of the monitoring your updates and translate them into Italian. All of this group love you and thank you. You really are a lot. You really mean a lot for us. Hope you enjoy our group.
2.0.
Please, Mike, don't give up. My name on Facebook is... Okay, I won't read that. Sorry, guys. I'm reading in cursive here from Italian. My real name is Christina. Much love. XOXOXO. Oh, on the back. If you can, please say hello to our group on Facebook, Gruppo Monteraggio Terremoti per la Italia, Michael Janich, Dutchsinse. God bless you. Much love. XOXOXO. We are from Central Italy. We are friends of William Pizzetti. Ah, okay. William, I need to talk to him. Oh, man, I keep meaning to... Thanks for reminding me. I need to send him an email. It's been so long. I've just been so busy. Tanto amore, which means much love in Italian, guys. I will write you back and you will get a letter back from me. Okay? Oh, this is getting to be so cool. So cool. Oh, we got printout. Hold on. Printout. What are the printouts? Much love. Please join us. This is for you and for us. Ah, okay, it's a screenshot. I need to join their group. Okay, I haven't joined the group. I need to join the group. Durr. Sorry, guys, I am sorry. I have not joined the group yet. I thought I did. I'll go do that right after I get done here. You guys should all go join the group. Go join the Italian group. It's Italian people posting Italian earthquakes. And they're keeping track of it and translating it into Italian. And the reason this all is going down, the reason I'm getting mail from Italy is because the last two big earthquakes that hit in Italy, I'm not bragging about this, I just have to tell you, that's why I'm getting so much mail. We put out warnings the day and 2 days before the big earthquakes hit. And it was the biggest earthquake in decades for the area. And so when we put out our warning and the next day it hit, the Italians made note of it, and they've written me many times to thank me, and that's what this is. And they created a whole group on Facebook dedicated to that, and these people live there. Okay, and here's an example of their of Chris. Okay, this is a translation. They're doing the translation, so you might not be able to see that. They're doing the translations for us, guys. They're translating it. Anna, Chris Montes, Lordana, Frederico, Francesca Rocci, right? Giovanna, Chris Montes. Guys, thank you. Thank you. Grazie. Grazie, as they say over in Italy. Grazie. I'm probably butchering that too. It's probably like grazie, and I'm like, grazie. I'm from the United States. Hello, I'm from the United States. I've got a cat in heat, if you can hear it. Cat in heat. She's going to get fixed. Don't worry, guys. She's the youngest. We let her go for one cycle, and we're going to get her fixed. Oh, wow. Hold on.
Come here. Oh. Meow. 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 Prow, prow, prow.
Are there any boy cats around? You know what? If I were to turn that up loud enough, if you've got a boy cat, his ears just went through the roof. Tanto amore. And she's going to be out there, guys. There's nothing I can do about it. I don't want to put her up or anything. She's just being a little girl. She's being a little woman second time. Okay, so, and she's not an outside cat. Don't worry. She's not going to be getting pregnant. But we want to have her have a couple cycles to, you know. Okay, anyways. So, next package. This one comes to me out of Canada from Campbell River, BC. Jennifer. And anytime I get an international pack, it says they have to declare what's on the inside, okay? And it says Christmas tree ornament. So, I you know, it gives away to me what's inside, but I'm sure there might be a letter or something inside too. Oh, you know what? I'm just going to have to tear this. Christmas tree ornament. Oh, I just took down the Christmas tree. Well, you know what? I'll hang it anyways. If I get a Christmas ornament after the fact, I will hang it. And it's going to, next year, and I will be here next year, even much greater than this year, by the way. Okay, let's get into the letter, and then we will go into the ornament. Ooh, nice penmanship. Okay, January 6, 2017. Dutchsinse. Okay, oh, and again, this is coming out of BC, Canada. If you guys don't know where BC, Canada is, let me show you. British Columbia, Canada is in the northwest of the U.S. And technically, BC encompasses all of the western coast of Canada. Let's get a sip of the beer. Hey, get your Molsons if you're up in... Meow. Okay, Dutchsinse, we had 4 big earthquakes today, along with a beautiful west coast storm. I could feel the energy shaking below my feet and an amazing force in the atmosphere. I started watching your videos every day since I've seen your energy wave discovery made on December 19, 2016. Ah, okay, the wave that showed up on Mimic. I've been posting your videos on my Facebook and emailing my local news stations, Global and CBC, the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation, and talking with people about all the things I have learned about the world from watching your videos. I talked with my energy friend, and she told me that this wave was the first of a couple more, and it was about creating balance. Your videos educate the public about our Earth, the destruction certain people have done to it, realizing and mapping it out where the energy transfers to, and they're talking seismic energy now, and possibly the Earth. I can't read. It's cursive, guys. Okay. The Earth's recycle system? If we all start to look at your writing's way better than mine, by the way, just so you know.
if we start to look at the fact that everything affects everything, we are, just as everything in frequencies, again, we can maybe start to the next level of human consciousness. A kind, caring, logical, and firm new world with balance in the class system brought on by new creative thinkers. You being one of them. Thank you. Thank you. The ridicule you have to go through to get to this point, I'm sure, has been exhausting, aside from having some great conversations with people about earthquakes on Van Island. I have also encountered many arguments with people with such closed views of the world. I do have to say the earthquakes today, or is that Friday or is that today? The earthquakes today validated to a lot of people, not me, I knew since the first video I saw that you have an amazing thing going on here. I feel like I want them to watch history being made and have so much faith and gratitude for your work. Thank you. I mean, this letter is just so, your assessment of me is so kind. I really have to say that you have been, but I assure that you are very overloaded with letters, and I heard them as I heard them before. I just feel so drawn to say thank you, though. This last year has been the worst year of my life, and watching your videos has inspired me in so many ways. It is life-changing. That might sound overstated, but please know it is... Please know it is... Did I get this right? It is everything affects everything. It's based from the compassion and care for all people. It elevates our frequency to self-love, and from all people, and from there, all people can succeed. And hold on, my cat is demanding entry. I've got a cat farm here. I've got four cats, guys. Three girls and a boy. The boy is fixed. One of the girls isn't. Wednesday, come here. Come here. You're trying to get away from the other. She's trying to get away from the other cat. The other cat's presenting to the girls. There's no... The boy is like, he's sleeping upstairs with mama, and the girls are all like, get away from me. Okay. Please keep up the good fight, keep educating people, and enjoy your life. You have done the groundwork. It is now time to get the recognition you deserve. Oh, thank you. I hope you like your Christmas tree ornament. Me and my brother-in-law made it for you. Every year, you hang it up. Please, take a moment to connect to the fact that I am a true fan and that you have connected so many dots for me in my life. I thank you very much for completing your mission and what you're doing and what you have to. Much love to your wife and cats. P.S. Please listen to Way Down We Go by Kaleo, K-A-L-E-O, on YouTube. They sing a beautiful acoustic song in a volcano. Oh, man, I'll have to go check that out. Wow. Wow. Well, I'm glad I've had a positive effect. I want to present much love. Living much love is so hard. Because, like, you know, I've been under attack a lot of times. And trying to... You should see the cat. Here, hold on. You should see the cat here. I don't know if you're going to see this. Look at this. She is all over that new cat mat. The new cat quilt. The cat is all over the new cat quilt. Isn't that hilarious? That's funny. That's funny. Whoa. Whoa, I'm half cut off here. Whoops. New cat quilt already getting catted. And that's incredibly cool. Okay, all right. So, thank you. And I'm glad I've had a good effect. And just living much love is so hard. But I have to come back and do it. Like just this past week when the people bought my domain names. Like, what do? You know what I mean? Like, first I got angry, and then I had to come back, and I had to, like, readdress and live the much love that I preach. Otherwise, I'm a giant hypocrite. So, anyways. Yeah, I'm so glad. And you know what? You ever come through St. Louis, look me up. Any of you guys, you ever come through St. Louis, let me know. What now, what do we have here? This Christmas ornament. Now, Wednesday, you are just going to... The cat is rolling over and over again, and just burying her head in this quilt. She's got both claws on it, like this. That's great. That is so great. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, this is a nice ornament. I mean, not that any of the other ones aren't, but this one is, like, heavy wood. It says, Vancouver Island loves Dutchsinse.
Look at this. Look at this, guys. Look at this.
And on the back, it has her name, Jennifer Fan for Life. And I'll block out her last name. And it's got like a little seismic wave. Isn't that cool? This is cool. And it's burnt around the edges. Hey, guys, as a carpenter, as a woodworker, you know, I love the burnt wood and the branding on that. That is so cool, man. It's branded. That's really what it is. It's, or maybe it's fine. I don't know how they got the burnt edges in there. But that's so cool. Maybe it's laser cut. That's so cool. So,
It has a, like a, almost a little bit of a campfire-y smell to it. Like it has a little bit of like that the burnt ember smell. That is so cool. Much love from Canada.
You guys are so nice. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Well, you know, that's just not going to go on a Christmas tree, guys. That'll just hang here in my office. I'll put that up on the side there. Well, all right. Let's go down the list. We got a few more to go. We got a pack here. And thank you again. That came from Jennifer. Now we go to Margaret from Ottawa, Ontario. And it's got a return label on here. It's got Ottawa Tulips on here. Now, I'm going to cover their return address and just show you all the cool stamps that are on here. I love getting international mail. It's, you know, even if it's from Canada, it's cool. I keep your stamps, I keep your envelopes, I keep it all. And it's just, you know, I don't know why I keep, I guess I, you know, it, you should keep it, but like I imagine myself in several years time coming back when I'm an old man and reading, you know, like, and just being like, God, that was, whoa, what do we have here? Something just fell out. Okay, yes, you can read it on air, 11th of January, 2017. Dear Dutch, enclosed you will find a few U.S. stamps from my late stepfather's collection. I have decorated your mailing envelope with some fancy Canadian stamps from that same collection. Wow, you guys know, again, I collect stamps. I'm not looking to sell them. I'm looking to keep them. I've got... a nice little collection that's again been passed down to me. And oh wow, these are incredible. Oh, you guys are so awesome. Out here, I'll show them to you in a second. Let me read these to you. Okay, I've decorated your mailing envelope with some of the Canadian stamps from that collection as well. So these are classic Canadian stamps as well. Really cool. I'll save the envelope, and the fact that they're postmarked out of Canada to me is even better. Also enclosed are copies from my earthquake file. After living through two China-rattling, plaster-cracking earthquakes in the Ottawa area over my lifetime, I'm not anxious to experience another one while living on the 14th floor of an apartment building just 3 miles or so from a major fault line running through the city. Now, guys, if you don't know about Ottawa, if you don't know about Canada, we're talking about over in southeastern Canada, eastern Canada. Okay, so Ottawa. But that's on the eastern edge of the Craton. Here, let's just pull up Canada. Okay, so, I mean, you get in here, you get into eastern Canada. Look where our red arrows go. Now, we have pressure that transfers up the east coast. We'll see 4 and 5.0 earthquakes that strike up there, and we'll see 4 and 5.0 earthquakes that strike in the Midwest before that. So first the Midwest is hit, then the Northeast is hit. It's crazy. I think that's where Ottawa, Ontario is. Here, let's pull up Ottawa, Ontario on a map real quick. Hold on. Hold on. Ottawa, Ontario. Oh, Canada. Oh, Canada. Come on, everybody. Okay. Let's quickly turn on display capture here. Yes, I was right. Ottawa is like right here. Technically, it's the capital of Canada, right? Right? It's the capital of Canada. Yeah, there it says down there right in the lower left-hand corner. But so, large earthquakes strike up here, but why? Why do large earthquakes strike up here? Well, I've explained it over and over again, and I'll do it one more time. Pressure comes across from the West Coast, dips down through the Midwest, and comes back up the East Coast. And look where our arrow passes over. Right where Ottawa is.
3.0.
And it's not just in Ottawa, but it's up to the Northeast, all the way out to east of Nova Scotia. You can see our crack, and it ultimately goes out here, and that's what happened over this past week, guys. Over this past week, we saw a swarm of earthquakes go right up into New England, And we talked about that over the past couple days. So that's wild, right? Okay, so now let's get into the rest of this. I noticed on your map that a red arrow, that a red arrow goes up along the St. Lawrence River into Quebec. I trust this is the same fault line that triggered off the quake in Lake Ontario described in my email to Environment of Canada? Does it have some connection to the New Madrid fault line? It is interesting what Environment Canada says about the geology of Niagara Falls receding about 3 feet per year. It would be awful if a major quake knocked down the falls and sent the water from the upper Great Lakes crashing down into Lake Ontario. Heaven forbid. Yes, heaven forbid that. It would take like a massive, massive movement of the craton for that to happen. We're talking like Yellowstone erupting or something. Okay. There's another interesting article on, quote, the 12 warning signs from animals, unquote, folks that should learn about. It seems animals know as much about the potential quakes as we humans are now learning. I trust that you have your pets trained to be on the alert too, as I have a little kitty sitting next to me still on the floor, and now she's just sitting on top of this thing. She's nipped out now. She's looking at things that aren't there. She's definitely nipped. Are you nipped? Yeah? Okay, cool. In the meantime, my friends and I are thankful for a site like yours to keep us posted as to the potential quakes in our area so as to be prepared. By the way, I'm sorry I missed your unboxing of my last two submissions as I got the message too late and your video was no longer available. All the best to you and yours for the new year in 2017. Sincerely, Margaret. The videos may be on Copper Tropical's channel. The night that I opened two of yours at the same time, my video got flagged for false copyright on YouTube and I disputed it and YouTube rejected my dispute. 3 hour long video had 10 seconds or 11 seconds of guitar at the opening, it was just in the background, it was at Christmas and it was like some kind of guitar playing and they picked it up and they flagged my whole video and they wouldn't let me remove it and they flagged me down for copyright. That's why I'm done with YouTube, another reason. 3 hour long video for 11 seconds. Okay, and what do we have here? Okay, we've got an email chain. I'm not going to read you guys the whole email chain. I like to read this kind of stuff. But it looks like we have an email chain between NR Canada themselves, Natural Resource Canada, and our fan here that's writing the mail here. Ottawa at risk for next big earthquake. News articles on this. Yes, Ottawa is at risk. Meow.
4.0.
And here we go. Here's our animal warning signs. Now, this is something my cat, I joke about it all the time, that my cat here sitting with me is the Midwest early earthquake warning cat, right? Like, and she puts off a mew, a M-E-E-W, and that is, of course, the earthquake warning. I joke about it, but it's true. On days where there's earthquake activity hitting the Midwest heavy, she's just through the roof loud, through the roof. Like today, she was through the roof loud, and look, New Madrid seismic zone right in the center of the United States got hit. That's right where I live. I'll read all of this. I'm going to read each one of these little printouts. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And the stamps. Come on. So let's take a look at what we got. Let's see. Uncanceled stamps, U.S. Okay, what do we have here?
2.0.
St. Lawrence Seaway stamps, guys. St. Lawrence Seaway. I've heard of those before, believe it or not. Each one of these are actually very collectible. Okay. United Nations stamps. United Nations. Wow. 1 cent omnibus U.S. stamps. Wow. Oh, wow. Oh, give me liberty, give me death. 4 cent U.S. 4 cent U.S. stamps. Guys, they're hard to come by. I mean, you really. 1985 Social Security Act anniversary stamps. Thomas Jefferson 1 cent stamps. 1 cent Thomas Jefferson's. What else do we have here? Old 8 cent Christmas stamps. Wow. A Henry Ford 12 cent stamp. Each one of these, I mean, we've got several. Mercury,
original four-cent Mercury project when the Mercury probe.
Meow. Yeah, I'll pronounce it right Wednesday. Wow. Really cool. Really, really cool. Oh, and we got some global stamps, too. Global Forever stamps. Oh, and one other. An 8-cent classic car stamp. Okay, guys, I mean, you know, look. I have to read each one to you just because I'm a stamp buff. If you're into stamps, you're going to be like, oh, that's really cool. And I, of course, put them in a special file and keep them and organize them. And eventually, someday, I'll show you. By the way, I got a... also, I have a rock collection that I do. So if you guys have any kind of rocks or special stones that you send, I mean, they don't have to be valuable. If you've got something cool that you'd like to show, send it. Send it, and I'll put it in my collection. So, all right. Here, let me put these all back in their proper way. So thoughtful. You guys are so cool. Thank you. Thank you. We will organize that. Wednesday thanks you for the quilt. Are you nippy? Not cold. Are you nipped? Oh, yeah. Her tail is fluffed. Okay. All right. This is fun. Let's get another drink of the beer. By the way, Mexico just got hit right where Guatemala,
2.0.
Guatemala. Right at the border of Guatemala. Close enough. Right next to the area where we warned. I bet that's about 200 miles. My realm of acceptability is 200 miles on that. So just...
Come here. Here you go.
Okay, all right. Well, we're going down the list here. Moving right along. Let's go into the next letter. I'm just shuffle. Let's go into the letters that were sent by Amy, who is one of our moderators, and she lives in Pennsylvania. So let's do this. Let's do it right. Let's open it up. Always love to hear from my moderators. What is going on? Oh. Look at that. Oh, isn't that a nice card? I still got my card wall going in the other room, and we got a couple more to put on there. One from Italy. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year, Dutch and Duchess. I hope you both have a great holiday and get everything you wanted. Have a blessed time with your family, and for family is precious. Season greetings and best wishes for the new year. Merry Christmas, Amy D.
God bless you.
Oh, and it looks like we got another. I mean, they both came in together, so I don't know if the post office was holding it in Pennsylvania. I know you guys had some storms there. My post office here, I threw them a pizza party. They're so cool. By the way, my post office, I guarantee it, guys, has gotten more mail for me than anybody else combined in all those P.O. boxes. I guarantee it. They were looking at me at the post office the other day. They're like, what are you getting all this mail for? I'm like, well, I kind of figured out a little forecasting methodology for earthquakes, and it's kind of got me recognition around the world. And they're like, what? Anyway, so bought them a little pizza party for this. Okay, so should I read this? Does it say anything about not reading? Okay, this is a handwritten letter. Okay. Mr. Michael Janich, I just wanted to start off by thanking you. And what you do for the world is amazing. Thank you for giving me the honor of becoming one of your mods. I really enjoy helping out.
Oh, come here.
Here, hold on. Hold on 1 second, Amy.
Come here.
Oh, are you nipped out now? You nippy? Here, let's see if we can read this and get through it. Are you going to let me get through it? Okay. For giving me the honor of becoming one of your mods. Oh, I appreciate all the stuff you guys do. It's dedication. I mean, I can't do anything for you guys other than say thank you over and over again and maybe, like, throw you a donation every now and then. Okay, I really enjoy helping out. I'm glad I found your YouTube channel thanks to Bud, and Bud is Edmund Kretzer, and his two wonderful daughters. And I hope Bud's doing okay. I hope the family's doing okay. And the wife. Okay. And to thank you and your viewers and your mods. Again, you give me hope that there really is good in the world. The fact that you are being censored and knocked down means you're doing your job. Just don't let them get you down. Tell the Duchess hello for me and thank her for sharing her time with you and with us and with the world. And I will. She's upstairs. But believe it or not, she's watching her and her sister are FaceTiming watching The Bachelor for some reason. I don't know. They're like laughing at something. I don't know. Okay. Tell the Duchess hello for me and tell her thank you for sharing your time with you and the world. I'm not really sure what else to say, and I don't really have anything of importance to say. So if my thoughts are scattered. I saw how upset you were with one of the last times you were knocked down, and I was pretty angry myself, so I made a group page on Facebook to support you and your work. We are at over 4,000 members, mostly Italian. So Eli, last, Marco, and and Sylvia have been doing a great job translating. I wasn't expecting it to be so big. It's called We Stand By Dutchsinse. I hope you have already seen it. Yes, I have. I have it linked down below in the description in my YouTube video. We Stand By Dutchsinse. I hope you've already seen it and like it. They can't knock you down because we are always behind you. We stand behind you because we believe in what you do. Stay strong, Dutch. You really are doing great. Much love, Amy D. Wow. You guys. I say wow all the time, but for real, like wow, thank you. You guys are really kind. It makes my day. Because you're right, man. Oh, they bought my domain names and stuff, man. Like, it was really bad this past couple weeks. Okay. Oh, all right, Amy. I'll be writing you back. Okay. Well, that's just thoughtful. How many more do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. Well, I mean, we could just keep going. Let's do it. Let's get her done. Let's get another drink. I'm not done with the beer yet. Here we go. Oh, okay. This one on the back, not public, no broadcast. All right, that's from Mr. Pink. That'll be a private thing probably. Okay, next one we have here. We've got Cranston, Rhode Island, but it's just a P.O. box return. It doesn't have any a name on it, so not a problem. Been through the mail. We'll assume it's safe. Very, very cool. You guys are all just awesome. And I love just getting letters. If you got a question or a letter, I will try to answer it. January 4th, 2017. Doesn't say anything about not reading it on air, so I'll just read it as I read it myself. Hi, Michael. I've been following your earthquake videos since you started. To me, you are the only reliable source for earthquake information on the planet. Oh, wow. Oh, man. Hey, I mean, thank you. That you don't know what kind of honor that means to me just to read that from a random person. Thank you. I'm a videographer and editor and very much in tune with how people watch video. I've wanted to write you for a while. Just a small critique regarding your presentations. No problem. Hey, I will read my critique open on air. Not a problem. As long as you don't cuss me out. Please limit your zooms on Earthquake 3D. Okay. I know where we're going with this. I'm aware. I've watched it myself and gotten kind of like dizzy. Many times, I think this has to do with how fast your mind works and how well you know your subjects. There are needless in and out zooms that make your videos hard to watch. Zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out. All the same place. Often you needlessly zoom in too far. Limit and slow down your zooms and pans and you'll be golden. Smiley face. Kind regards, Fred. YouTube channel? Okay, I won't give out your YouTube channel. Not a problem, guys. You gotta understand. I don't watch my own content back. I never watch my own video. I don't like the sound of my voice. Even when I process a video, I will just go one end to the other, put my intro on, put my thing on, and I'll throw it up. I do not watch my own videos. So when I go back and watch it, I'm like, whoa, I was on the big screen and I'm zooming in, zooming out, zooming in, zooming out. And it's just a bad habit. It's a bad habit that I'm used to. I'm trying to make a point. So like if I'm talking about an area and I'm like, you know, West Coast of the United States, watch out. Okay, you know what I mean? Like, you know, I'm thinking that. I'm thinking, watch out, you know, and so I need to lay off the roller. And I got a new mouse. I got the new mouse. So the conducive to rolling has been very, very easy lately. I'm going to put tape over it. You know what? I'm just going to turn off the roller. And then if I want to zoom in and zoom out, I'll actually have to move my hand, and then it'll only zoom in a little and out a little bit at a time. Now that cat, got hair all up in my nose. That's crazy. Okay. She is laying on it now, grooming herself. Whoops. Wednesday. Meow. She's laying in the torn paper from the package and on the catnip itself. That's a sign right there, guys. Okay, so next up on the list. This comes to me from Maplewood, Minnesota. And this is weird because my P.O. box is in Maplewood, St. Louis. So there's a Maplewood, Minnesota. Oh. From me to you only. Okay, all right. Well, I've got two I've got to open private. I'm glad I looked at that. This comes to me from Sand Springs, Oklahoma. Nope. Here, let me get their name off here. Hold on. Okay. So it says, in case you didn't read the screen, don't read on air, only for your eyes and ears only. And this comes to me from Betty. Okay, personal. Okay. Three to open, personally. I bet it's having to do with when I had my meltdown about SO and those guys buying my domains and getting shut down. I bet you when people heard me on there, they're like, don't give up. And I got multiple letters regarding that. In case you guys don't know, my biggest hater online bought my domain names, and they apparently have owned them for a while. And I went to go get my domains, and I found out that my biggest hater owns them, and they bid me up on my own .com, made me pay $400 for it, for a $5 domain. I had to pay $400, and now I know who did it to me. It's crazy. So I got all bummed out on the stream, and rightfully so, right? So your biggest hater owns your domains. So I guarantee you there's going to be some talk about that in those letters. Okay. And I'm over it now. I had to forgive. I forgave him that night, actually. But first I had my meltdown. Then I had to come back and forgive him. This comes to me from Roger out of Monroe, Ohio. And such is life online, guys. I mean, you're going to always have a hater no matter what you do, no matter where you go. Even at your own, like, you work a job. I'm sure you guys, if you're an adult and you've had many jobs in your life, I'm sure some of you have worked at jobs where you didn't get along with either an employee or a coworker or a boss or whatever, and you know what I'm talking about, right? Okay. You got to muddle through, or in school. If you're in school and you've got, fellow students you don't get along with. Now, sticking out the edge here, I see something, but let's read the letter first. We've got a donation to the cause here, guys. Thank you. Wednesday, give us 25 meows. Two. Oh, we'll let the other cat in the other room make up for it. Row. Row, row, row. You got 50 more to go. Okay. Dear Dutch and the Duchess, we are old school, so we're sending a check. Hope it isn't a problem. First of all, look at the immaculate handwriting on here. Look at this. This is like reading in a dream, okay? We are old school, so we're sending a check. Hope it isn't a problem. Not a problem. I appreciate anything that's... Oh my God, what is going on? I'm just going to keep reading. Hold on. Oh, this is great. Should I let her in? Should I let the other one in? Here, hold on.
Come here. It's okay. You're a little woman. You're a woman now.
There are no boys. I know you're looking for boys. There are no boys anywhere around. No one can help you or service you. I'm sorry. There are no kittens to be made here. Okay. Dear Dutch, let's try it one more time. Dear Dutch and the Duchess, we are old school, so we're sending a check. Hope it isn't a problem. Not a problem. We watch your programs all the time and appreciate your gift. It really sucks how the powers that be, and that's in quotes, harass you all the while you're doing good deeds around the world. I and Roger do hope you know the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, I do, guys. I used to be an atheist punk rocker. And along the way, I don't talk about my faith much. I try to keep it off the, you know, I mean, doing earthquakes, it's, you know, I mean, you're talking science, you're talking the driest science topic in the world. So I keep my personal thing, my personal faith out of it. But yes, I have accepted Jesus as my Lord. Look, that sounds cheesy, right? Look, I've done things that break God's law. If there is a law, I've broken it, right? That's what I've accepted. And that I need some kind of saving from that, because it's like having a pardon. It's like getting a pardon for something bad that you've done. If you believe in frequency and you believe in positive and negative, look, I'm not going to get too new age on you or anything. This is just a common scientific fact that if you have a negative, you have a positive. To have a negative, you have to have a positive. Just by logically speaking, for there to be a negative, there has to be an opposite of that negative, and that negative opposite is going to be a positive. For every waveform has a peak and a valley. Okay, an up and a down. Okay, so if that holds true in nature, it also follows through that it would happen with actions and thoughts and all those other things that seem like they're not real, like your thoughts and your actions. People would think, oh, there's no consequence to that. Well, why wouldn't there be? There's a consequence to every other thing in the physical universe. So that's where the whole concept of sacrifice and the whole concept of all these weird spiritual concepts come into play. And that's all been satisfied. You don't have to sacrifice. You don't have to do any of that stuff. It's all been taken care of for you. All you got to do is acknowledge that you messed up. And that there's no way that you can actually make it right. Like, you messed up your frequency. What do you do? You have to make it right. I don't know how to describe that. But if you follow Jesus, that's a good explanation I hope you guys agree with. I and Roger do hope you know that Lord Jesus Christ. I read about the comments and the Dutchlings make, and it's very sweet and entertaining. Although we have never joined in the conversations, we are still a part of it, and may God bless you. Roger and Sherry? Wow. Thank you for the kind thoughts. And I don't talk beliefs, guys. Look, man, I still got all kinds of failings, man. Look, I'm drinking a beer. I cuss. Look, I'd like to think that the disciples, they were fishermen, right? And Jesus was a carpenter, right? You know, I'm a carpenter, right? Name me one job site that you go on where you don't hear an F-bomb. I don't care what century you're in. And the fishermen, come on, we know fish. Come on, everybody here knows about fishermen. Fishermen are like, look, if you want a rough and tumble crowd, get with some fishermen, man. Go party with some fishermen for a little while. See how you come out. Okay. All right. So here we go. We're down to two more letters. We've got, this one doesn't say anything about not reading on. Now, this one was postmarked on January 12th, coming out of Sycamore, Illinois, from Patty. Okay. Well, let's cut the bottom of this open here. Oh, what do we have here? What is this? Look at this. Do you see this? It says, they grow. Bloomin' flower cards. Shady backyard garden. Look, the seeds are in the paper. Plant them. Whoa, we got some cash. Cash money. Hey, be careful when you mail. My post office is excellent. The people there, you could send hundreds of dollars. Okay, they're cool. But I don't know elsewhere. I don't know, you know, I mean, there's, I'm not saying there's any bad people in the mix or anything. Sometimes it could be even somebody who is not affiliated with the post office who scans those post boxes and stuff, you know? So be careful. But thank you for sending money. Every little bit helps. So tomorrow, by the way, the stream's going to be down while I'm putting in the video card and getting my internet connection worked on, and they're going to be coming here and stuff. So stream will go down tomorrow. Do not be shocked by that. But this card, hey, guys, look, I mean, I can plant this in my backyard. This is so cool. Dear Michael, thank you for your dedication and tenacity for sharing your brilliant work. You're a pioneer in earthquake predictions, and your videos are warning people worldwide. Well, let me stop right there. Thank you for your kind assessment of my work. Please have a beer on me. Ha! Hey! Hey! Cheers, brother! Sister! I'm sorry. Sister! Oh, y'all. Facepalm. Facepalm. Cheers, sister. Sorry. Usually when it's like, have a beer on me, it's like coming from one of my buddies. You know what I mean? It's coming from Tat. Tat's like, go have a beer. I'm like, thanks, buddy. All right. Please have a beer on me. I love watching your videos. Exclamation mark. The whole world is truly blessed to have you warning us worldwide of pending earthquakes. May God bless you, Patty. Directions for growing are on the back. The shady backyard garden. A handful of annual and perennial wildflower seeds are embedded in the handmade paper of this gift. Plant it, and they will grow. This mix includes the following seeds: sweet William Pinks, purple coneflowers, baby's breath, lance-leaved coreopsis, spurred snapdragon, monkey flower, forget-me-nots, Chinese forget-me-nots, baby blue eyes, corn poppy, Johnny jump-up, columbine, Shasta daisies, Clarkia, rocket larkspur, and candy tuft. Wow. That is cool. Oh, wow. You know, guys. Hey. You are so cool. Thank you, Patty. Thank you very much. And thank you for making a generous donation to my cause. Okay. We are down to one more. This is it. Here we are. This comes to me from Joanna out of Oregon. Out of Oregon? Is that right? Joanna out of Oregon. I think so. I recognize the zip code on there, and I think I know the handwriting. But then again, a lot of people's handwriting looks the same. It's easy to get confused. Oh, wow. What do we have going on here? What is this guy? Is that a... What is this? A Walt Badger, 1982, by Beth Van Hosen. Okay. Dear Dutch. Once again, here's to hoping every good thing comes your way. You don't have to read this online. Oh, okay. I just wanted to correct a misapprehension. You have me confused with another Joanne in Oregon. What? Oh! Another Joanne in Oregon. That's weird. I was just talking about how you could confuse handwritings. Huh. Wow, that's synchronicity. Another Joanne in Oregon. The one who sent you that wonderful honey, which we buy also. Oh, okay, you sent me the In Search of Ancient Oregon book, hoping that it would help research on the Earth's crust, and the Pacific Northwest in particular. Okay, you sent me the book! Okay, I'm sorry. I thought you were the Joanne from Oregon who sent me the honey. That was in the last video, okay. When you read my note, you attributed the honey package to me as well. Okay, you're a good person for letting me know. And thank you for the book. I've already went through it. I've already gone through it twice, actually. Once when I was in a debate, a verbatim debate on my Facebook channel with somebody from the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network. Not John Vidali, but one of his followers came over and they were saying something to me about Oregon. I went and looked it up in the book on the mud pot, or not the mud pots, the Newberry Crater geothermal operations there. Anyways, So I've already used it twice. Hard to keep track of all the people I noted today. You were trying to answer the 75 letters. Yes, and I've gotten through all of them now. This is the last one. Well, now I've got three that I still need to read. But yeah, 75. And then the additional packs that you don't even see sitting here on my desk. There's a stack there. That's what I've gone through in the last 2 days. In the last two videos, I mean. So, amazing, right? I mean, my viewers have just gone above and beyond in their generosity and in their inquisitiveness and in their creativity. So, all right. Should have credit where it's due so she doesn't feel left out. Okay, thank you once again. And rely on your good work and seeing your bright spirit on here. Many thanks and much love, Joanne in Oregon. The badger is rare, intelligent, creative, self-sufficient. Any parallels? Maybe just on one level, you have a big heart to add to the mix. Oh. Oh, Joanna, thank you. And you've got a big heart. Yes, we'll give the appropriate credit to the second Joanna, who ironically has similar handwriting. YouTube Mandela effect. Here we go. It's your future self writing to me from the future. All right, guys. Here, cheers. Let's bottoms up. Okay, this is a nice little chug here. Oh. Ooh. I don't care how good the beer is. When you chug it, man, it'll put an extra hair on your chest if you're a guy. Or it'll put a hair on your chin if you're a woman. So be careful. All right. So. All right. There we go. We got all the packaging. This has been another phenomenal opening. Thank you to the people from Italy. You have been phenomenal in your response. Thank you to everyone who wrote me. I'm going to write you back. So you'll get something back from me. And I think, let's see here. I think I'm going to start doing the giveaways this next week for my Dutchsinse mugs, which in case you guys haven't seen, I've got a box of them here now. I'll autograph this one since I opened it. But no, for real, look at this. This is so cool. Look at this, guys. See this? It's got the Dutchsinse logo on it, right? And on the inside, it's orange. It's orange with the orange handle and the orange Dutchsinse logo. I'm going to be doing giveaways when we play multiplayer video games as we're talking earthquakes. And you guys can join in. That's the cool part, is you'll be able to actually play against me and animatronic. And if you blow me up and you beat me in a death match or something, as we're talking earthquakes, we'll have microphones so we can talk. We'll talk earthquakes while we're playing on dead time only, not when there's a big earthquake happening. But when there's nothing going on a night where it's pretty quiet, we can be gaming with each other, talking to each other, and I will be giving away this kind of stuff so that you guys can get something back for spending your time here with me. And check out this one. Look at this one. This one's even cooler. It's cool. It's just as cool. It's Animatronic's logo that he made for me. And I'm going to be sending two of these, one of each, to Animatronic, who made the logos for me. But this one's cool. It's black on the inside, white handle. It's got the Much Love logo on the front, and it says Dutchsinse down at the bottom. Yeah, really cool, man. So I'm not, you know, again, I've never had this kind of stuff to give away before. So I just think it'll be something cool. I've got, like, basically 10 of each mug, so I can give away 20 mugs. And we'll do that over the course of a few weeks of game playing and contests, that kind of stuff. So, you know, if you can beat me, which will be pretty easy because I totally am a noob. No, I'm kidding. I'm not. I can hang. I'm no... You know, I'm no lawnmower man, but I'm definitely doing okay, you know what I mean? So, younger viewers won't even know what I'm talking about there with lawnmower man. Okay, so, have a good morning, afternoon, evening, or night, depending on where you are. Truman Show style, so get your Makoko and look into the camera that's installed in your wall socket. And have a good morning, guys, seriously.
Thank you for sending me stuff. Thank you to tanto amore to the people in Italy for being so kind when you're already going through so much. Look, you're already going through so much. You don't have to send me anything. I just want to help as much as I can. If I see something coming, like what I see coming in Italy over the next week, I will get on and tell you. And if it's not going to come, or if it looks like it's going to fizzle out, I'll tell you that too. If I'm wrong, I'll tell you. If I'm right, I'll tell you. And I'm here 24/7, 365 at this point, or at least 365. Let's just call it that. I'm here 365 days a year. And now that we've got the new video card and the new RAM that's getting installed tomorrow, should be great. The stream's going to go down tomorrow. Do not be alarmed. It will completely shut off on Twitch. It'll shut off on YouTube. It'll be down for probably several hours while the video card, RAM, drivers, internet connections getting reset and worked on by my cable company here. So it might be down for several hours. They told me it could be like up to 3 hours for them to actually have it off. So if it's off for 3 hours, hey, you guys all, you got your copies of Earthquake 3D, right? And Tats, you can go over to Tats' channel, Tattooed1009, who's also running a live stream. And what you'll see pop up on my Twitch is I've put Trainee TV on there for the train video guy that we went over and gave a much love bomb. I put him and Animatronic on as viewing when I'm not streaming on Twitch. So there'll be something on my channel, and it'll be one of their channels that'll pop up on my channel when I'm down. So it won't be completely dead. Okay? All right. So that was great. And again, if you guys have a question, I will answer it. So tonight there wasn't many questions. I've got three I've got to open off camera that are going to be probably more personal. But if you have a question, I would be happy to answer it. But every person has sent something thoughtful and nice, not just a question. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'll be back in a little while. I'm going to go save this as a video on my YouTube channel, and then I'll be back on. If you guys want to check, I'll still have stuff saved on YouTube. Don't think I'm leaving YouTube entirely, but I am moving away from that. That's another tool in the tool belt, right? Hopefully. I mean, I don't know where we're going to go in the future. YouTube hasn't been terrible to me. It's just I got shut off many times. So I've got to, it's my business here. If I get shut off, what am I going to do? I got to go somewhere else. It's not that I want to. I felt like I was being shown the door, So I don't know. It might not be. It might just be a technical issue or something. Got to give them benefit of the doubt. But we'll wait and see. Maybe YouTube will improve the service and I won't have to worry about having to totally quit. Okay, so word up. I'll be back. Peace out. Cheers.